It's feared whistleblowers will be silenced under a raft of Newman government changes to the crime watchdog. State political editor Kathy Border reports the CMC now has the power to prosecute any complaints deemed vexatious.
As expected, the government will implement a raft of recommendations from the Callanan Review into the Crime and Misconduct Commission.
Malicious, vexatious, baseless complaints will no longer be able to be made to the CMC.
The CMC and whistleblowers face significant changes. Whistleblowers must sign a statutory declaration. They can't make the complaint public. The CMC must prosecute vexatious complaints. And under right to information changes, departments must not reveal any CMC investigation. Whistleblower nurse Tony Hoffman was crucial to the Bundaberg Hospital expose. Supporter Beryl Crosby is worried the CMC changes will stop insiders blowing the whistle.
Look, I'm absolutely appalled. We need to be encouraging whistleblowers, not actually suppressing them more than they already feel suppressed.
Others see some improvements.
The proposal to ensure that complaints are made without you being able to make a press release that a complaint's been made is a good idea.
After launching a public service purge, the Newman government also has changes in store for public service managers. Managers must ensure their staff don't commit official misconduct, and if it happens, they could be liable.
This move is to make politicians unaccountable for everything.
The opposition wasn't available to speak about the CMC overhaul or the senior public service changes, and that $57,000 poly pay rise is full steam ahead.
We're sticking by it. We're sticking by it pursuant to the legislation that currently exists in Queensland.
Kathy Border, 10 News.